How to create a QHP application. Issuers seeking to offer qualified health plans, or QHPs, including standalone dental plans, or SADPs, on the federally facilitated exchange must submit a completed QHP application per CMS guidelines. As part of the QHP certification process, issuers are asked to fill out several templates with issuer and plan level data. These templates, along with any supporting documentation submitted, comprise an issuer's QHP application. Issuers offering QHPs or SADPs in federally facilitated exchange, or FFE states, submit the majority of their QHP application materials in the Marketplace Plan Management System, or MPMS, module within the Health Insurance Oversight System, or HIOS. The MPMS module is a web application that allows issuers to submit QHPs and SADPs to CMS for review and certification, as well as validate plan data prior to submission. All issuers seeking certification, regardless of state exchange model, require access to the MPMS module. Although issuers in states performing plan management functions and state-based exchanges on the federal platform, or SBEFPs, will continue to submit the majority of their QHP application data to their states through the System for Electronic Rates and Forms Filing, or SERF, before that data is transferred by their state to the MPMS module. Issuers in states without an effective rate review program and issuers that do not have access to SERF use the Unified Rate Review, or URR, module in HIOS as well. For more information on submission systems issuers use to submit QHP application materials, including guidance on how to access those systems, visit the Submission Systems webpage of the QHP Certification website. For more information on which submission systems issuers in different state exchange models use to submit each QHP application material, reference the QHP Certification Issuer Toolkit posted on the Application Submission webpage of the QHP Certification website. The MPMS module is divided into four primary sections. Home, where issuers access announcements pertaining to their applications, metrics about any applications they may have started for the current plan year, and easy navigation to other areas of the system. Plan Validation Workspace, where issuers upload QHP application templates for validation and receive validation results prior to submitting their applications. QHP Applications, where issuers create or edit applications, link valid templates uploaded in the Plan Validation Workspace to their applications, complete attestations, provide supplemental application documentation, and access review results provided by CMS, and Application Tools, which includes the application materials page, where issuers download certain materials, issuer details, where issuers update their machine-readable index URLs, and plan preview, where issuers preview and validate the accuracy of their plan benefit displays for healthcare.gov. Issuers create new QHP applications in the QHP application section of the MPMS module. Issuers in states performing plan management functions and SBEFPs must create an application in the MPMS module before their state transfers their data from SERF. This ensures the correct market and product types are associated to the application. If SERF submitting issuers do not create a new QHP application prior to their state transferring their application data, the SERF transfer will trigger the creation of a new application that may include incorrect market and product types. Now let's walk through how to create a new QHP application. To create a new application, navigate to the HIOS MPMS module and select the QHP Applications tab. Then select the plan year and issuer combination that you need to create a new application for. In the final two drop-down fields, select the options that reflect all product offerings and market coverage types you intend to submit data for as part of your QHP application. Click Create Application. If an FFE issuer has uploaded validated files to the Plan Validation Workspace, they can choose to link those files to their application now. After creating a new application, you'll be prompted to select any valid template XMLs available in the Plan Validation Workspace to link to the new QHP application. Only files that have a status of No Errors Found or Warnings Found can be linked to an application. Each listed file will include the template type, file name, the user it was uploaded by, and the date and time it was uploaded, and the associated validation result. Select the checkmark next to any files you would like to link to your application, or click the checkmark at the top left of the pop-up to select all available files and select Link Files. If you do not want to link any files to your application at this time, select Cancel. After creating an application and linking any validated templates already uploaded to the Plan Validation workspace, you'll be taken to the Application Overview page. A green banner will appear indicating you successfully linked a template, if applicable. The Application Overview page allows issuers to view all required components of their QHP application. An application is divided into individual groupings within the MPMS module. Each application grouping is made up of application sections. After you have uploaded templates within the Plan Validation workspace, created an application, and linked any validated templates to your application, the Application Overview page displays this application data along with the date by which each application grouping must be submitted to CMS for review and feedback. Individual application sections will display one of two statuses: in progress or ready to submit. Each application grouping will display a status of not started, in progress, submitted, under review, corrections required, or no action required. Issuers are able to view and edit each section by selecting View or Edit to the right of the listed section. Please note that some application sections require you to complete attestations or provide application data within the user interface. Clicking Edit next to any application section takes you to the application section page and allows you to view any validated templates or supporting documents that have been linked to your application. The section page will also display any attestations or additional data that issuers are required to provide within the user interface, if applicable. To link a newly validated template to your application after it has been created, either select Link Files from the top of the Application Overview page, or navigate to a specific application section and select Open Workspace to be directed to the Plan Validation workspace. From here, you can upload a new template XML and link any valid templates by scrolling to the bottom of the page and selecting Link to Application. A pop-up will be generated where you can select the files you'd like to link from the Plan Validation workspace. Once all desired files are selected, click Link Files. This option is recommended if a new template needs to be linked to the section of the application you navigated from. After making your selection, you'll be redirected back to the application section page, where the newly linked template will display. Selecting the Save and Complete button completes the application section and returns you to the Application Overview page, where the application section will display a status of ready to submit. If a warning was identified for one of your validated templates, you can click Add Document in the Supporting and Justification Documents section of this page to upload any required justifications or supporting documentation. Select the document type from the drop-down menu, select the desired file, and click Upload. Once the file is successfully uploaded, it will appear under the Supporting and Justifications Documents section. Then select Save and Complete. Issuers have the option to remove any uploaded documents by selecting Delete File. Once a file is deleted, the action cannot be undone, though selecting Upload Again will allow issuers to re-upload a file. Issuers can also download uploaded files by selecting the file name. Continue to link and unlink validated templates to your application and upload necessary justifications and supporting documents until all sections required for the upcoming submission deadline display a status of ready to submit. If you have questions regarding how to navigate and use the HIOS MPMS module, please contact the Marketplace Service Desk at cms_feps@cms.hhs.gov or 855-CMS-1515. For more information about the QHP certification process, visit www.qhpcertification.cms.gov.